said, in a non-linear reality, past, present, and future are an entangled event and not separate from each other. Please tell us about the concept of influencing one's past experiences with the practice of voluntary effort.
There is no experience without anatomical participation. You could say that experience is a behavioral act. A memory is a behavior. It's a neural behavior, if you want to put it that way, located in the brain. But when you say located in the brain, we're talking about structures. We're talking about axons and dendrites and neural bodies and synaptic junctions and pathways that are laid down that are reflections not only of the neural pattern, but of the muscular action's participation. So that we are now talking about when you talk about a behavior, it is always or an experience, it's always accompanied by micro or macro muscular acts. Just trying to remember is a particular act. Just trying to reorganize how you want to say it is a muscular act. You got to control the tongue and the mouth and so forth. If you have the ability to voluntarily imitate an emotional posture like being angry or being fearful or being concerned, if you could assemble that, you say, show me how you're concerned, you have a chance to edit an instinctual pattern that's generating feelings, and in reassembling it in a voluntary way, you're adding information that alters the anatomy, that alters the experience. And if repeated enough times or with enough intensity, lays down pathways that acquire duration, meaning the axons and dendrites and neural bodies in the synaptic place begin to fire in a particular new way that makes those pathways have duration. People do not know insight, experience, ahas really are anatomical events that are searching for more body. Because even though you know something cortically, it has to be translated into action. And you may not know how to act. You will do what you know. You may say, I know how to act, but I still eat the chocolate. We haven't learned the delay mechanism.